Yeah, so hello everyone. Myself, Ria. I'm an associate software engineer at Red Hat since last 1 year. So here I am. I'm going to talk regarding a tool that I have been working on named PBench. So this is the topic of today that I'm going to talk about, that is distributed system analysis made easy with PBench. So let's get started with that. So today's agenda that we are going to follow to know about PBench is what is PBench, why do we need to use PBench, components of PBench and how they interact with each other, available scripts and tool that helps us to run PBench, dashboard that helps us to visualize the results that we collect with the help of PBench, the installation steps that are going to help you if you want to use it. And there is also a demo that I will be going through. Then where can we get PBench and how you can contribute to it. So let's get started with the most basic question that comes to our mind whenever we listen about PBench. That is, what is PBench? So PBench in general is a benchmarking tool, benchmarking framework that helps us in consistent and complete benchmark data collection. So what is a benchmark data collection? So benchmark is a kind of the point of reference that we use. Like when we wanna run things, like we have to set something for ourselves. Like I wanna reach a goal till 5 day or 4 day. So that is a kind of benchmark that we set for ourselves. So the same kind is benchmark scripts, which consist of some particular tools or which consist of script that we can run and collect the particular type of benchmark that we want to run, that we want to collect data about. Like we can include SAR tools or PERF tool or whatever tool we want to add into that, we can add them and then we can just run the benchmark. So these are some of the components that PBench consists of. Agent, server, and a web UI dashboard. And it's a work in progress project. So it is under progress and we are still working on it. So how we come into, how the idea of PBench came into play. So nowadays we are mostly dealing with distributed systems. Wherever we see there are distributed systems all around us. So when we try to collect data being in a team, it gets quite problematic as many members are there in a team. There are different data, like there are different viewpoints of each person. Similarly, when we try to collect data from each member of a team, we get different results. So these are the problems that we face when we try to collect data from a team, and there are different results, and like we want to collect kernel information of a system for around 10 seconds. So what do? We just ask each and every person of our team to collect data of the information regarding that and send them to a particular location. So then we just ask them to send the result and we can go through that. But what happens if the result that is collected is not consistent? That is the problem where it rises, because people have different environment they are working on, or operating system, or different things that they must have installed in their system, which leads to different performance results, due to which the data collected is almost different variable from each other. So that's where the problem arises, and it quite makes the things quite impossible or delayed. So so for this problem, we found a good solution, and we came up with some of the best practices that we can include, and we created a tool that can help us collect a consistent data. So we created an agent, server, and dashboard, which I'll be talking about further. And this project has been in work. We have been working on this project since 2015, and we have collected around 2,42,000 plus starballs, and they have been allowed around 12.2 plus terabytes of data. And it is mostly because we don't have a delete button yet, but we'll be working on that soon. So let's see that how we can work through that. So next is why pbench. So we have seen the problems that we have encountered while dealing with different systems or when we are in a team. But why do we use pbench? So when we are in a team, if the collection of inconsistent and incomplete data creates the problem. So pbench is kind of framework that helps us to that helps us to that helps us to collect data around a particular benchmark. Like we can just ask each and every member of our team to install the pbench and collect the data. And being the same tool that is collecting data and having consistency around it makes it easier for people to use it and have it and use it and create the consistency in team. Because when we are in a team and we ask them to collect data there, so we follow different rules to collect the data. Like if someone will be following different script to do that, and other will be using some other method. So there are that's kind of good, and we get to explore a lot of things. But when it comes to consistency, it's quite difficult. So that's why pbench came into play, as it makes it easier to collect data and required configuration and tool data that we want. And it also helps us ensure consistency. We are sure that the data will be consistent as it has been recording, reusing the required tool that we wanted. There is a provided central location where we can collect all the data. There is server for that. I will be talking about that in the workflow. We can reuse this data as much as time we want, as there is a server where data is being collected, and we can just fetch the data whenever we want and reuse it. And we can also run, if the data has been collected from different system, we can run comparisons between them with the help of dashboard. So what are the components of pbench? There are mainly three components of pbench, that is pbench agent, pbench server, and dashboard. So what does the agent do? What pbench agent does is it helps us to run the scripts and collect data. Collection of data is the major task of pbench agent, and it helps us to collect the data around whichever benchmark we want. Like we have given it a script and just run the benchmark, and it will just collect the data about that and wrap up in a tarball and just send it to the server. That's what pbench agent is. Pbench server helps us to archive the data. It helps us to see if there is any problem in the data, because if there will be any problem, then it will just discard the tarball and see and remove it to see that whether there's an error, and it will report it. And it also, if the tarball is fine, then it will just index it and moves it further. So the last component is dashboard, which helps us in displaying and compare the components, the tarballs or whatever results we have collected. Next is the workflow. How does pbench work? So the workflow that pbench work is on, as we know, means the agent, pbench agent can be installed in any number of system as you want. There can be any number of agent as we want, as much we want, and there can be as much as server as we want. So it's just about how much data you want to collect, from how many users you want to collect, and where you want to store it. Then what we can do is we can have as many agents as we want and just run the pbench on them, collect data from them. And just what pbench agent does it? It collects the data around the particular, collect the data whatever user wants. Then it just logs it, and then it's binded together in a particular tarball, and then it sends it to server with the help of pbench move results command. So we can so as there are many agents, they are all connected with a particular server, so that the data can be collected and not just go to waste. Because the pbench agent only does help in data collection and nothing other than that. So we can also use the robot for our own use. We can just run the payment agent and use the Tabul data that we have collected and whatever we want to use it for. And or we can send it to server for further processing if we want. Then payment move result helps us to send data from agent to server. And then what server helps us to do is it helps us in filtering, unpacking, and indexing of data. It helps us to filter if there are any problems or errors in the Tabul as it unpacks them, then process it again in the server. And it went through different, it goes through different steps. Then it then indexes it so that it will be easier for us to visualize it later in dashboard. So it goes to Elasticsearch with the help of pbench index command. Then what Elasticsearch does is it maps and indexes all the data that we have collected, and then the data is fetched by Kibana or the dashboard that we have created. There's a particular dashboard that we use, and we have created that, and we can run any number of comparison that we want on that. And there's also a Kibana instance that we use, which helps us to for thorough introduction to the data, as we can add as many information on that as we want. Like if we want to know the host name for the data, or username, or machine ID, or how it has went through, whether it is failed, what data is that collected. It consists of all the information, and we can visualize it as easily as we can. So this is the complete workflow from agent to visualization, and it is it's quite easy and helps us to know the basic understanding and workflow of PBench. So as PBench consists of many scripts and tools, we can say that it consists of many scripts and tools that I'll be showing further. But there are some of them that are means quite used quite often, and I would surely love to go through them. So some of the benchmark scripts, they are also known as workload. They are the workload is the amount of work that is performed by an entity in a given period of time. So we just these are the script that performs our work, whatever we give to it. And we can just provide the time, and it just run through all of them and provide us with the data. So what does pbench user benchmark does? Pbench user benchmark is a custom benchmark where the user can define their own tools and tools through of which it wants to collect data. Like there is a particular tool set that we have, default tool set that we have in pbench that consists of SAR, IOSTAT, MPSTAT, PIDSTAT. So if we are using a default tool set for our collection of data, then it will collect all those information and it will send to us. But as it is a pbench user benchmark, it can also create its own tool group, and it can collect that info as well. Like it can just add the tool with the help of commands in a different group and just run it with the help of pbench user benchmark command. Just need to add some we just need to add some additional options to that. So what does pbench 5 does? It is a workload generator that can be used for both benchmark and stress hardware verification to check how is our hardware managing with the system. Then pbench upf help us in network performance testing, like how our network is working, if we are connected from one system to another, how it is dealing with that, how much time it is taking for that, and all those information. Then there is pbench traffic gen as well, which helps us to run traffic generator to test network. We can just run them with the help of different, like I think there is one moon track that helps us to run different traffic generator and just test the network. So these are some of the benchmark scripts that we can run and collect the data on that. So the different tools that we use for collecting these kind of data is is SAR, IOSTAT, AMPISTAT, PIDSTAT, PIMSTAT, PERF. So what does these tool help us? Tools are means basic. Tools are the little programs that helps the main program for debugging or any other process that a program wants to run. So tools are some small programs, and some of them are SAR that helps us to collect system activity report. It collects all the system activity report that are going on in the system while we are running something. And then IOSTAT used for monitoring input-output activity. Then AMPISTAT helps us to monitor CPU utilization, that what all CPU utilization we are doing at that particular point of time. Then there is PIDSTAT that helps us in that helps us to know the individual process ID that are managed by kernel. We can know we can do any process ID that we want, and we can monitor them with the help of it. And then there's VMSTAT, that is virtual memory stat. It helps us to know about all the memory and paging and process that is going on. Then there's also PERF, that is one of the most important and detailing. That is the performance monitor analysis tool, provides access to the closer look at behavior of hardware. So these are some of the scripts and tools that that we go through that helps us in collection of data, and these are the scripts that helps us run them, and these are the tools that helps us collect all the data that we want to collect. So this is a look of dashboard that we have constructed. So this dashboard helps us run comparison visually. Like we have collected all the tables that we want from different users, and we can just pass through this dashboard and we can run the comparison between them, like which one means whatever comparison we want to run. As here we are running log average time or num job or runtime that we have. So all the whatever comparison we want to run with all the results that we have collected, dashboard helps us in that. So for running a dashboard to get all these results, there are different steps. Like there are results that we have to tell that which table we want to run comparison with. Then there is also comparison select that helps us to select all the comparison that we want to perform on that table. So and after that, we can just run the comparison, and we can see all those things visually. At the end, there is a Kibana instance that I talked about. It, as we can see here, at present, it is consisting of time, at what time the table that we wanted to collect is collected or sent here. Then it tells by which host name that it has collected from, then the name of what script it has gone through. Then it tells the PIDs, then it tells the doctor that it is a status or a report, then the text that it has passed through it. Like how, like the first one, we can see it has showed that there are zero process tables and zero partial with zero errors or zero duplicates. So all this information we can get easily with the help of Kibana. And in the left side, we can see that there are much more information that we just need to add them for ourselves. Like there is one selected fields option. So we can just select the one, those are below, like index, we can add to selected fields. Or chunk ID, we can add to selected fields, and all these things we can just add to selected fields, and we will get information regarding all them. So there are just three easy installation steps for PBench. First, what we need to do is just clone the PBench repo. Then we just need to set up an inventory file and run Ansible scripts. So we can clone the PBench repo from the GitHub, and then we can set up an inventory file. We have given almost all the steps that how we can set up an inventory file, and we can run the Ansible scripts. Ansible script consists of all roles and configuration that are that should be there, all the files that are important, like configuration files that are most important that helps us to set up the things where they should be. And we can just run the Ansible script, and it just it gives all the paths and all the configuration that we need for running PBench. So PBench is compatible with different distributions of Linux. It basically we have tested with these three, like RHEL, Fedora, and CentOS. We have tested with these three, and it has been really fine working with them. But we will be still testing them on different environment and making it as platform environment platform independent as much we can. So as I've mentioned, then there are some that this project is a work in progress project. So there are some upcoming features that I can mention here, and we are working on them. So the basic conversion that we are going through on server is conversion from all shell script to Python 3 scripts, as earlier it used to be in shell. So now we are converting that to Python 3. Then addition of new features like deletion of unpacked tables. Then, as I have said, that there is no delete option in we have right now, so we'll be adding that soon. And there is also an introduction of user notion, so that we don't delete other people's data, and that is most important. So the conversion that agent is going through is, it is also going through conversion to Python's three scripts. From bash scripts, then having a unified platform for tools. Yeah, unified platform, we are working on that, and we have created one, and it's going fine. We are on testing phase of that, and it'll be out soon. Then in the dashboard side, we are working on conversion to Patternfly. Dashboard is working on conversion to Patternfly, and then we are also implementing user notion in that, and also data sample migration. So next, here are some slides that I can share, that I can go through and help you know about how we can run the PBench. So here is a PBench agent that I have installed on my own system. And as after running the PBench command, I can see the different commands that it has listed through, like PBench add metadata option. Clear tools helps us to clear all the tools that we have already added in the PBench. Then there is PBench kill tools if we don't want to collect the data anymore and we have started that already. And it just kill the tools that kill the tools data collection. Then PBench make result table, it helps us to make the result tables. Then PBench register tools helps us to register tools, while PBench register toolset helps us to register whole toolset that we wanna that we have created or there is already that is already present there. So here is I have used a PBench register tool with the name of SAR. So I have installed a tool, SAR tool here, and with the help of PBench register tool --- name SAR, I have registered the SAR tool there, and the group is default, as I haven't mentioned any group name. So if we are running PBench register tool set, then these are all the tools that we have mentioned in a these are all the tools that we have mentioned in the default toolset, as we thought that these are good for a default toolset and will be useful for users. So these are all the default toolset tools that consist of there. And as we can see, with the help of PBench list tools command, this is the default tool group, and these are all the tools that are present there. So here in PBench register tool --- group light --- name SAR, this is where we can create our own user group with the group name as light, and SAR tool I have included in that. So it has just installed the SAR tool and registered it in group light. And as we can see after running the pbenchlist tools command, that there is a default group with the name of with the consisting of all the tools that are there. And there is also a light group that consists of only SAR tools. And we can add as many tools as we want in that light group according to users. So for running a use benchmark, we can just, here I have run a benchmark, pbench user benchmark, and it will be run for 10 seconds. So it is running for 10 seconds and it has collected all the system information that we wanted. Then here I have shown the default directory that we have provided for collection of tools, and we can see that the pbench user benchmark, this is the collected tarball. Collected result that we have, it has collected and it has shown here. So pbench move result show server helps us to see that on which server we are going to send the data, and it will just we can just pbench move result, we can just run pbench move result command, and it will just forward this whole collected pbench user benchmark to that server. And as we can see that the pbench user benchmark is not there, and it must have moved to server. So this is the installed server where I moved the pbench user benchmark that I have collected in the form of tarball, and it has moved here, and it is well with the .md5 file, which is the unique ID that is it consists of, that helps us to recognize that, that helps us to separate one tarball from the other. And this MD5 is quite unique. So I would like to point out that how we can get involved with pbench. So there is one GitHub repo of distributed system analysis pbench. So we can just go there and clone the repo. Or there is also one Google Groups. We can just go to that and get joined to it. So are there any questions?
Yeah, so there were two questions. Maybe I can read those out, or I can, yeah, just let me read those out. So first one was from Bharadwaj. How do agent configure to a particular tool? So I think we saw that, right? I mean, we saw in that in a demo. Yeah, maybe you can still answer. I mean, what is the command and how that works, something like that.
Yeah, with the help of pbench register tools, we can just run the pbench register tool with the group name that we want, hyphen hyphen group, and whatever group name you want to give, as I have given light there, and the name hyphen hyphen name, and SAR, as I have given the tool name SAR. So it will just create a different group for us and a different and add the tool whatever we want to add to it.
Right. Next question was, if pbench agent can be used on Windows.
As I have mentioned that we have only tested that in these three operating systems, like RHEL, Fedora, and CentOS. It would be good if you will try to run it and help us be it more platform independent, but we haven't tested that yet on Windows, and I won't be able to answer that yet.
Yeah. So basically, get understanding, so it's basically like a way to collect all the stats in a standard way and pass those to the server so that people can analyze, right?
So people can analyze the system or whatever means whatever performance they want to see in the systems.
Right. And these tools, so basically these are some standard tools which we saw. Is it possible to add own tool or something?
We can surely add if they are open source, and we have, and there are many more tools. These are not the only tools that are there. There are many more tools there, and I have just mentioned the standard ones that we have added in before.
Right. So basically, we can try to contribute to extend it that's the
way,
right?
Sure. It's open, it is available on GitHub, and anyone can come and contribute to it.
Interesting. And when we say we are running benchmark, we will have some script or something which will actually do some work, and the data will be collected by the agent, right?
Yeah, it will be collected by the agent. Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. Got it. So it's a nice idea. Basically, standard way to collect things so that we know what we are collecting and how it is getting collected, basically.
True.
Yeah. Let's see if we have any questions. Nope. Nice. Thank you. It was very interesting. Surely everyone should check that out. Maybe I can post link to the GitHub repo in chat as well. Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Thank you, Ria.
Thank you.